Red Dead Redemption 2 is one of the greatest games ever made, but let's not forget where it came from, because Red Dead Redemption was also a very good game. Unfortunately, there's not many options to play except getting an Xbox 360, PS3, or PS Now service. I do not have any of those, and I hate playing with a controller. Luckily, we have PS3 and Xbox 360 emulators, so playing Red Dead Redemption on PC is totally possible. Plus, you do not need a controller to enjoy the game. Let's get started. I chose Xenia, an Xbox 360 emulator, because it utilizes graphic card power to run games instead of CPU. So first, you need to download the game files. I can't tell you where to get them, but make sure to download the this one and this two version instead of the Game of the Year version. To run the game at 60fps, I found a Xenia config file on this guy's YouTube channel. I'll have the link of his video where you can download the file in the description. Once downloaded, the file needs to be renamed to xenia-canary.config.toml. By default, the game was set to run at 720p, but I changed mine to 1080p cause I have a beefy machine. You can also download custom patches to improve the performance or get rid of the FPS lock. Extract the patches folder to the Xenia folder. Go to the patch file of the game and enable which one you prefer. First, it would be Red Dead this 1 or this 2. Here I picked Unlock FPS Patch. All the stuff are not necessary for me, but they may boost the performance if your PC is too weak to run the game. You may also need to comment out the hash value if the patches are not applied properly. To enable saving, simply create a text file and name it portable.txt. After that, you can open Red Dead and play the game. Just launch Xenia and open the default .exex file in either disk 1 or disk 2 folder.
Stuff is for sale, but I'll take a look at any extra stuff you're carrying.
Howdy. Oh, hello.
Howdy.
Greetings.
You can set up AMD Fidelity FX Super Resolution to make the game look better. By default, it is very blurry. Hit F6 to launch the configuration. To make the game look clearer, enable AMD FSR 1.0. I set FSR at 8.084 stops and CAS at max, but you can play around the settings until you are satisfied. If you feel the game is too overshopped, you can enable anti-aliasing, and for me, normal quality is good enough. By just turning on and off these settings, you can see how much different the game is, and it is so great for our eyes. The game is playable if you have a controller, but I prefer mouse and keyboard, so we need to install and launch Virtual Controller. Then head over to Settings, I/O Devices, Virtual, Setup, Xbox 360, then install VirtualBus, then restart Windows. Relaunch Virtual Controller and we can now enable Xbox 360 gamepad. Click on Configurate and choose Plugin to activate. Next, go to Settings, I/O Devices, Physical, Setup, and choose keyboard. Click on enabled and lock feature. For API, we use LLHook. Choose setup, mouse, choose enable but untick lock feature because it causes virtual controller to crash. For API, choose raw input. Then go to ASUS settings. For sensitivity, I personally set to 1800%. Then download the virtual controller profile in the article, which is a VCD file. In virtual controller, go to settings, load, and open the VCD file we just downloaded. Then go to settings, controls. Here we need to replace the mouse of the order with our mouse. As you can see, it cannot detect the mouse. So click Ctrl A on your keyboard, go to tools, device replacement. In target, choose the wrong mouse. And then replacement, we need to choose our mouse. Because I have two mice plugged into my computer, so it shows up two devices. So I just randomly pick one, but for you it should be one device. With that, we successfully set up the mouse and keyboard for playing Red Dead Redemption. To activate Virtual Controller, launch Red Dead Redemption with Xenia, then Alt-Tab to Virtual Controller and hit F5 on your keyboard, then go back to Red Dead to enjoy. To play Xenia in full screen, you can hit F11 on your keyboard. One final problem is, I don't know how to hide a mouse cursor, so I created a completely transparent cursor, which can be found in the description. But if you know how to, please let me know. I also highly recommend you to bookmark the article because it shows the equivalent keys to the button of the controller. Finally, here's the summary of how to launch the game. Open Red Dead by opening the default.exex file. Then go to the mouse settings to change to a transparent cursor. Launch or Alt-Tab to Virtual Controller and hit F5 to activate mouse and keyboard. Then Alt-Tab back to Xenia, hit F11 to play the game in full screen mode. So, how is this game in 2022? Well, Grand Theft Auto 4 was out in 2008 and people still play it till this date. This game came out later in 2010. It is the reason that many people demanded Red Dead 2. I have not completed the game, obviously, but I am loving it so far. For performance, the game runs great in nearly every part. When you enter a town like Armadillo, there may be FPS drop, but it goes back to 60 plus immediately. I also tested the game on my parents' Ryzen 5 RTX 3060 PC. It has no issue with running above 60 FPS. And that's it for today's video. I will have all the links you need in the description. Please like and subscribe if you find this video helpful. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.
Can't herd, can't swim.